Hey there, welcome back to PS Desire. I'm excited to be here with you to share something really cool. In this video, I'm going to show you a step-by-step guide on how to create an awesome outline text effect in Photoshop. But before we start, I just wanted to say a quick thank you to all of you who have been supporting me and my channel. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel so you don't miss out on any of the new content I will be sharing in the future. It would mean a lot to me and help me create even more helpful tutorials for you. Okay, let's dive into the tutorial. So the first thing we need to do is open the image that you want to add the text. I already picked out a great image to work with. In order to make your text stand out and look really professional, it's important to separate or remove the background from the image. But don't worry, it's not as difficult as it sounds. We will be using the Select Subject option in Photoshop. It's a quick and easy way to extract the subject from the background without having to make a perfect selection. All you need to do is select the Select Subject option and let Photoshop do the rest. It will automatically detect the subject in your image and create a selection around it. The next thing we need to do is to copy the subject selection that we just made and paste it onto a new layer. This can be done easily by pressing Ctrl or Command plus J. This will create a new layer containing only the subject. Once you have done that, it's time to enable the Type tool in Photoshop. This tool allows you to type over your image so you can add text related to the photograph. In this case, we are going to keep it very simple and just type the word nature. Feel free to get creative and come up with your own text. We are going to duplicate the text layer by pressing Ctrl or Command plus J again. Then we will drag the duplicated text layer and place it beneath the subject cutout layer. Here is a simple yet very effective trick that creates a cool masked text effect. We need to select the top text layer and reduce the fill to 0%. Now you should be able to see the subject layer through the text, making it look more integrated with the image. We are almost done, but there is one more thing. It's time to make the two text layers move together by linking them. To do this, simply click on both text layers while holding the Ctrl key and then click on the link icon. This will create a link between two layers, so when you move one layer, both will move at the same time. Now you can place the text wherever you want and it will move in sync with the subject layer. This makes it easier to position your text exactly where you want it without having to adjust each layer separately. Now let's take it one step further and add some awesome layer style to your text. Start by selecting the top text layer and double clicking on it to open up the layer style dialog box. Here we're going to apply a stroke effect to the text. You can adjust the stroke size and color to your liking depending on your image editing needs. These are the settings that I used for my stroke effect. But feel free to experiment and come up with your own. Once you are happy with the style, go ahead and click OK to apply it to your text layer. This will add an awesome outline to your text and make it stand out even more. And next, this is an optional step. To take it one step further, let's change the blending mode of the text layer to overlay. This will blend the text into the image more naturally and create a more cohesive look overall. And there you have it. The image now has an awesome masked text effect with an outline. I hope you found this tutorial helpful and easy to follow. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you never miss out on our latest exclusive videos. By hitting the bell icon, you will also receive notifications of our future tips and tricks. We appreciate your support and look forward to bringing you more helpful tutorials in future. Keep practicing and creating, and don't forget to have fun. See you again in the next video. Take care.